Today we are discussing about blacksmithy, how to draw blacksmithy diagrams. The first one is the converting of square rod into the circular rod. First we have to draw raw material dimensions. Just we have to draw one horizontal line. Next we have to draw one vertical line. What the procedure we have to follow in the carpentry section? Same way we have to follow here also. There is no change. Okay, just identify the origin point here. Take a protractor. Take 30 degrees in only left hand side, don't take in right hand side. Just to join this point and this line, this point. Very lightly. Now measure one mm, sorry, 1 centimeter. That is nothing but 10 mm. Okay. Now draw vertical line with a dimension of 1 centimeter. This 10 mm. Again, we have to draw 1 centimeter line here, that is parallel to this line. Now join these 2 points. Okay. Now extend this line up to 15 centimeters. That is equal to 150 mm. Up to here. I'm taking from 2 now, that's right, up to 17 mm. Okay. Similarly, here also, take scale parallel to this line and move in this direction. Draw 150 mm line here. Similarly, here also. Again, take scale parallel to this one. Move in this direction. Okay. While drawing this line, just check, cross check once again. This scale parallel to this side and move in this direction. See here, some small difference is there. That's why I have the link. Just switch. Take scale parallel to this one. Move in this direction. Now, join this point and this point. Join this point. This is the raw material. Okay. Now this raw material will be converting to the circular shape up to 120 mm. Remaining 30 mm in a square shape only. Again, we have to take one horizontal line. Next, take set square. By using set square, we have to draw one vertical line. Just extend this vertical line up to this point. Okay. Identify the origin point. Take protractor. And place the 30 degrees angle left hand side. Now again join this point and this origin point and draw 1 centimeter or 10 mm line in this side. Again draw 1 centimeter and here one vertical line, that is permit this one. Okay, now join these two points. After that you can erase and insert line out of the extra lines you can observe here. And this to 30. Okay. Now similarly, from this point also, just take care of this one. Again, here also. So we have to draw one vertical line. Okay. That vertical line is exactly parallel to this line. Just take scale parallel to this one. This direction. Draw one vertical line. Okay. And extend these lines up to this line, this vertical line. This is the 30. Total length is 150. Now we complete 30. What is the remaining? 120. From here, just we have to identify the 120 mm arc. This is the 120 mm. Just in this 120 mm. We have to draw one vertical line and measure the distance. How much distance this one? 1.5. Exactly here to here 1.5. That means 0.750 diameter. Take 0.75 diameter on this line. 0.75. Just measure by using scale, not 0.75, 0.4. 0.4 is the diameter. Okay, take 0.4 diameter radius and draw one circle. I am repeating once again. From here, we have to take 120 mm distance. In 120 mm distance, we have to draw one vertical line. Okay, there is no dimension for this vertical line. Just we have to draw one vertical line. From the bottom, we have measured the 0.75 distance. From here to center point, 0.75. Take, this is a center. Radius of the diameter is 0.4. Okay, by using 0.4 radius, we have to draw one circle. Or directly we can draw the circle by using the 360 degree circle. Okay, just highlight that circle. Okay, now take scale parallel to this line and move in this direction, draw one tangent. How much distance the tangent is? The tangent distance is 115 only. Don't draw up to 120, up 115. Okay, similarly here also, draw one tangent up to 115. Okay. Always this lines parallel to this one. See here, small difference is there. Some mistake is there. Just arrange that one. Take scale parallel to this line. Move in this direction. Okay. Now join this one and this one. Actually this joining is takes place by using the
circles present on the 360 degree circle or free hand. After that we can highlight this tangent line, this tangent line and circle. Now we have to provide dimensions to this diagram. What are the procedure we have to follow in carpentry? Same procedure we have to follow here also. Don't deviate procedure. Just draw one line with some distance. How much is one? 150. Okay. I am mentioning the all the dimension in the format of mm only. We also maintain same procedure while providing dimensions. That is the standard way of presenting all the dimensions. This is 10 mm. Okay. Next, write here all dimension in mm. Okay, next scale also 1:1 here, because what the actual dimensions we are taking for the preparing the circular rod, same dimensions we have to mention in the drawing sheet also. Due to that reason, we have to mention here 1:1. But reducing of these dimensions means 1:2. That means 150 in place of 150, 75 we can take. Okay, thank you.